welcome back. So in this tutorial, we'll be looking on one more topic. So one of our subscriber, Kamlesh, he came across one requirement, okay, where the client asked for a report, okay, on a C configuration item table, and that report should is around that he wants to get all the duplicate names through that report. And I found that it's quite an usual scenario that in our day-to-day life, right, whenever we do some kind of discovery or we do say some kind of data load on a configuration item, so it happens that there will be a duplicate record, duplicate CIs with a similar name, okay, and we always need to get the report out of it, okay, what all CIs have duplicate names. I also faced this in the past, so I tried to explore the solution for the same. So in today's tutorial, we'll be looking into the solution for the same. We'll create a report to get the duplicate CI names. Okay, so let's jump into our personal instance, our favorite personal instance. So as you are aware about, this is our personal instance interface. Okay, so if you go over here, okay, let's try to get it. So we'll be doing on the reporting on the CMDB CI table. Okay, so let's try it out. So if we go to reports, okay, I will create new. Okay, in create new, why it's so till it's getting loaded. Okay, please. Okay, great. So now let's give it a name as get, or I will give duplicate CI report. Okay, I think this is fine. The name suits the requirement. We'll be doing it on table. The table name will be CMDB underscore CI, or we can simply do configuration group. So let's try, where is our CMDB CI table? It should be over here only. Space configuration item, I don't want, I want configuration item. We got our favorite table. Oh, for today's demo, this will be our favorite table, not an incident table. So report, this kind of reports are quite important to in terms of the validation purpose. So what I did, I just created a duplicate report. Okay, I given the name, date, source type is table, table on configuration item, and let's see what we can do. So here the report got generated. We want it in this format only, and configure. So if I do, I can do one thing. Okay, people will say Kiwi Amit is not using some common sense, that we can simply do group by name. Okay, and if next, okay, so what it will do, it will load the report and it will group by name. Perfect. Okay, and you can see there are two, these are the duplicate records. There will be pretty more. Okay, download manager also, there are three, but our requirement is we just want to see, and it's pretty specific also, we just want to see the records which have duplicate. Okay, when you give the heading for the report as duplicate CI report, so why you want to see is show the CIs which has encountered only one time in the system, right? So we just want to show the CIs which got duplicated, right? Okay, like this one. Okay, not the 1111, right? So for this, how we can do, because on reporting we don't have any kind of provision, we can see we can't put any kind of filter also which will vanish this one count, means a single unit CIs, right? So let's do, so how we can do that, for that what you can do, you can create a script include. So let's create a script include. Script include, okay, and in script include, we will create a new script include, and we want to define one function only, right? So we create a classless script include. So let's give it as name as get duplicate name, CI name. This will be fine, okay? So let's give the name as get duplicate CI name, okay? It will create a class, but I don't want to go with this prototype, okay? I will simply remove this thing out, okay? And let's create a one. We have to enable this callable function, client callable one, okay? Let's have it accessible from all the scope, okay? And let's define, I have just removed the follow-up code, and I will simply define one function, and that function name should be similar to this, identical to this, okay? So we will give function name. Now people, I know people will give, add a lot of comments, if I am doing this, please drop a comment, I will give the answer for the same, okay, in the next video. So let's give dup record. Okay, it's dup message for duplicate record. I will define an empty array. Now the next step will be like, we'll be using glide aggregate because we need a count, right? So, and we will be, I will try to put a condition where count is greater than 1, we'll show only those record. So how to do that? If you have not seen my glide aggregate video, you can, you must be seeing on the screen, okay, in the info message. You can follow that video out. So let's do variable glide aggregate is GA, okay, and we will do duplicate check equal to new glide aggregate, okay, and we'll give CMDB underscore CI because we are doing this on, you can extend it on any table based on your use case and requirement. So we will do GA duplicate check dot add aggregate, on which we want to add aggregate, we want to add aggregate of type count, and on field what is name, is that name. Then the next step will be like, but now the next step will be, we are putting a query on name, but there is a chance that name can be empty and we don't want to entertain with an empty name, so we will get add not null query, okay, that means name should not be null. We'll give name again. Then what else we want, let's do group by also over here only. So we'll do GA duplicate check dot group by again name, okay, what else is remaining? We want to put the condition, count condition, right? So we'll do GA group check dot add having, if people don't know what is add having method, please drop a comment, I will create a video on the same. So it's like a conditional statement, okay? So like I am putting over here, where count is greater than, you can put the operator greater than 1, okay? So you can read it like, where count is like attribute, field and value. Oh, sorry, attribute, operator and value. Okay. So I have greater than 1. And then we'll do GA to check dot query. Okay. And while, if now we have done the query, now while this GA dot query, sorry, dot next, till the time it has a next record, what we want to do, we want to push that particular record sysid to this array. So let's do that. So we will do dup record dot push, okay, and we want to push the sysid name. Let's put the name, okay? So I will do ga dup check dot get, or let's not go name dot, it's a string for don't wish, so I will do get value of name. This is the right format, not a dot working. Okay. If you don't know the answer for this also, I have created a video on the same also. You can check it out. Oh, so much of promotion today. So I have created a function. Let's save it out. It's pretty simple. I will explain you once again. So what we are doing over here, we have defined a function called getDupCI. We have defined an empty array. Now we are doing a glide aggregate. We want to find the count of name. We have done the group by of name, not null query we have added. We have added a condition. We want only those records whose count is greater than 1, only those name, and I have pushed those name to this array. That's it. And we will be returning this array. So last step I have missed. So that's why we should always look into the code after we are done with the coding, right? So perfect, it's done. Now what we have to do, now we have the same script include name is same to the function name. Now I will take this name, and what we can do, how to put this, now we want to put this logic into our reports. Okay, it's pretty simple. Okay, how you can do that is simply go to this report. We want to put the condition on name, right? So we'll give name is, and we will give the, we will call this particular function over here. How to call it? The way we call it in reference qualifier. If you've not seen that or that video also, please check my playlist, okay, for that also. So JavaScript colon, and we'll put the script include name. I think that is it. Okay, that is it for generating the report. Let's try it out. Okay, if we run this report now, oh, it worked. So now we can see only records which are duplicate. We got the report for the record which are duplicate only. Okay, no other bullshit. Okay, I should not use this language. No other single records. So this is how you can achieve this. Okay, the way Kamlesh reached out to me in terms of with by putting it in the comments. Okay, you also can reach out to me. I will try it. I'm trying to resolve all your queries. Okay, I have a stack of incident, stack of comments. Okay, I will be creating video one after the another. Okay, till then, please like, follow, subscribe. Stay with me in the journey of ServiceNow learning. Let's learn together. Okay, like, follow, subscribe. Okay, and always stay happy and stay safe. Okay, till then, thank you. Have a nice day. Good night.